I'm very pleased to present to you today our center's 2017 IVF Outcomes. As those of you who follow our various program presentations, either by video or through our newsletter, know, it is always in March, April, that we can present the preceding year's outcomes. And we are very pleased to be able to report again a rather spectacular year for IVF outcomes at CHR during 2017. What was probably the most surprising statistical outcome was the radical change in age of our patient population. Our patient population for the last half a dozen years has been the by far oldest of any reporting IVF centers in the US and probably in the world. But what happened between 2016 and 2017 is really unprecedented, because within 1 year our median age for IVF patients went up by a full year, from 42 to 43. Imagine that, our median age being 43. And in practical terms, that meant that we had women up to age 52 go through IVF cycles. Now, obviously, we haven't had a pregnancy in a woman with use of her own eggs up to age 52. But we reported in 2017 the birth of our oldest patient ever to conceive with use of her own eggs and to deliver a baby. And she was only 2 months shy of age 48 when we transferred her, and she was obviously into her 49th year by the time she delivered. So, quite a remarkable year for CHR, as this was not the only patient who was so close to age 48 when she conceived. We indeed had another patient. Unfortunately, she, however, miscarried. Those are probably the two oldest patients ever to conceive with use of their own eggs in a fresh IVF cycle. We searched the literature and were unable to find a patient who was older. That in itself is obviously a remarkable achievement for CHR. Our rates for the younger population in 2018 were again excellent. They were excellent because they rated on a national average. And you may ask, how come they can be excellent if they are just on a national average? Well, the answer is that they're so excellent because our patient population is so different. Even our younger patients, in the vast majority of cases, come to us only after they have failed a number of cycles, often at different IVF centers. They usually have high FSH levels and low AMH levels, in other words, low ovarian reserve. And therefore, our 25-year-old or our 35-year-old patient is not the average patient in that age group that most other IVF centers treat. It's the 35-year-old patient who has been to a number of other IVF centers, has not gotten pregnant, and only then comes to us, and then still has remarkably good pregnancy rates. So it is important that when you look at our age-specific pregnancy rates, you consider that. Another very interesting observation was that our older patients started separating into two distinct groups. Our patients over 44, as I said, up to age 52 in fresh cycles, dramatically increased in numbers. Indeed, they represented a whopping 35% of our IVF cycle population, a huge increase in numbers. But again, interestingly, our patients in the 43-44 group, they declined during 2017. What that is telling us is that some of the other IVF centers, which until recently really rarely accepted patients above age 42, probably have started doing IVF cycles, while still barely anybody will accept a patient above age 44. Our pregnancy rates in patients above age 44 obviously were quite low, as one would expect, but they were much better than it may appear, and it is important that this be well understood. We reported in a number of publications that in older patients, besides age, the most important prognostic factor for pregnancy is how many eggs and embryos they produce. And that especially after age 43, a woman really needs to produce 3 embryos in order to have a decent pregnancy chance. And by that I mean a pregnancy chance in the double digits. And it's obviously better if she has 4 or 5 or 6 embryos. The same or very similar results were recently in a large study also reported from our colleagues at Cornell, who reported in their program that they needed in those women at least 4 embryos. So those results are very similar. What it all means is that in much older women, there are really 2 patient groups. There are those who have better chances, and there are those that have poorer chances. Well, there's obviously a third group, which have such high hormones that they have no chances, and where we recommend, or at least strongly recommend, that they go directly into egg donation. But amongst the patients who do still have a chance based on their hormone levels, there are those 2 groups with better and poorer chances. And what differentiates between those 2 is the number of eggs and embryos that they still can produce. And in counseling patients at those age groups, that is a very important distinction, which until a few years ago, we were not aware of. But we now know it, and therefore, it is important that you, the patient, understand the importance of egg and embryo numbers for your chances.